Hi there, welcome back to my channel Scrap and Coffee. I've got a quick project share for you today. I've came up with a quick, fun, easy folio completely made out of cardstock that would be perfect for using your 6x6 paper pads. So if you're looking for projects that hold about maybe 20 photos and use your 6x6 paper pads, these kind of folios are perfect for it. So I think it was at the end of January that I showed my home folio that I did in my Facebook group, and this is like a spin-off of that folio. So you will recognize some features, but I've changed it up. So again, I've used it on a previous project as well, on my Pocket Galore folio. I've used the Coffee and Friends paper collection by Echo Park. A really fun collection. Mostly I've used my scraps from that project, but I did got into some papers of a new collection pack. So what I did on the front cover here is I just cut out some pieces out of the collection and I used some embellishments to create this cover here, and I think that turned out pretty fun. This is actually from the stamp set. I'm not really a stamper, but I thought it was a nice feature there. And then I haven't covered the spine yet, still need to do that. I have some details that I still need to do. And then this is the back side. And when we open it up, I need to stuck that down as well. There we go. We have this little, mirrored image here. It looks the same on both sides, and that's throughout the whole folio. So I have a pocket here for some, you could crop down a 6x4 photo and place that in here, but it's, you need to crop it down slightly. So I have some smaller photos in here, still need to do my detail work on there as well. But I had opportunity to film and I need to take that opportunity, so. Then these two, we can open it up. And then I have full size photos here. I have about 10 full size photos in this little folio. And you can add more, but I also added some pattern paper. And then we can also pull this out. And another full-size photo there. I didn't do anything on the back, so it's a little bit easier to get it in there, but you could if you really want to. So I'm going to put that to the side for now. And then we can open this up. I have a stacked pocket here. You could leave it out to reduce some bulk, and you can also add another full-size photo then if you want to. And I just put in some things here. You can put something larger in this top pocket because it goes all the way to the bottom. And then some photo flaps on this side. I've used some photo turners to keep that closed. So here I did opportunity for a 4x4 photo. Then here you could place a full size photo if you want. I have one on the inside. And here I've created a little belly band with pattern paper. Maybe I'm going to do a little embellishment on top of here, but I haven't found the right one yet. And then here I can place a photo on the back side and room for some journaling there. And then we can close this again. And we can open this one up. And then again, I have two full size photos. So here I did landscape photo and this was supposed to go somewhere here. So that is what that would look like. Then we can close all of this up again. And then here on this side, we have the same thing. So I can pull this out. And here I've rounded the corners and I forgot on my other one. It was already stuck down, I was too late. And I prefer to round it because you might bump your corners a little bit with sliding it in and taking it out, so. And then we have the same features here. Full size photo, that stacked pocket. So here, this was a cut apart from the collection. That is, I think it's 3.5. And I've cut it down in height slightly in order to make it fit. So now it's 5.75. So it's, I think originally it's 6. So, but in order to fit, and I needed to cut it down a little bit. And then another photo opportunity here. The flaps again, and you could also turn these two flaps around if you want to. So then it go, the 4x4 will go from here. Again, the belly band with some journaling opportunity, photo opportunity on the back of this. And I think it's just fun, it's quick. If you need a last minute gift, this would be perfect. It took me about 2 days to make this, but I don't have a lot of time to craft with 3 little children. So let's say a morning and an afternoon, that's what it took me to come up with the design, make, construct it, and embellish and put on my pattern paper. So, and if you know me, you've seen some of my tutorials, you might know that I'm not so fast. So there we go, all of that can fit in there again, and then close it up. And I might add some ribbon here, or you can do a closure, or whatever you like to do. So yeah, I think it's a really fun folio. I bulked it up a little bit, but that's okay. You can leave some features out if you don't like that, but with these type of folios, I don't really mind. So for this, the tutorial will come up on my channel tomorrow, maybe the day after, but pretty quick. And the cutting guide will be available on my website, and I will put a link down below in the description box. So I hope you like the project, and if you do, let's give it a shot and make it. So thank you for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Bye bye.